family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. You can be better informed, more motivated, and more effective. Subscribe to our fact-filled newsletter, follow us on Facebook, check out our YouTube channel, listen to our podcasts, and keep up to date with all of our projects at ruthinstitute.org. Father Paul Sullins is once again a guest of Drew Mariani on his eponymous show on Relevant Radio. They're discussing fornication and sexual sin in the Catholic Church.
I'm joined by Father Paul Sullins today, who knows this intimately. He's an emeritus professor of sociology at Catholic University of Washington, D.C., but he right now is the senior research associate at the Ruth Institute and a great sociologist. He's actually a married priest. He was a former Episcopal priest, was ordained to the Catholic Church in 02, and I always love to tap into his expertise, both in terms of culture, sociology, but also the faith. And Father, thank you for joining me. Such a delight to talk to you.
Good afternoon, Drew. It's so glad to be with you.
Yeah, you know, years ago, Father. No, go ahead.
I was thinking while you were talking about the seriousness of fornication that it's also the most harmful of sins to the person committing it. I was thinking where it says in 1 Corinthians 6, every other sin a man commits is outside of his body, but the fornicator sins against his own body. Imagine that. Someone is degrading and diminishing their body. They don't know it. They think they're having a great experience or a great relationship, but you're actually reducing your capacity for sexual expression and for love in the way that God intended you to have. So if you think of the person that God intends you to have sex relations with, and I think that for almost all of us, God does have someone in mind, a particular person in mind. Yeah. If you fornicate with someone else, it's harder to connect with that person later on. St. Paul says, you know, if you become joined to a prostitute, you become one body with that prostitute.
Wow.
In a way, you exchange spiritual parts with that person. You may not intend to, but you do. And then when you go and if by God's grace, you go on and you're able to find and be joined to the one that God wants you to be with, it's a blockage. It doesn't totally ruin it. I don't want to say that, but right. So it makes it difficult.
How do you get over that? Because there's a lot of people listening saying, man, oh, yeah, I slept with this many people before I finally met my husband or my wife.
Yep.
What happens? I mean, because I think this is a really important point. You carry into that relationship, you know, those souls touch, so to speak, you know, and you make this connection. How do you bond with the one God created you for, and how do you detach from the hooks of those previous relationships?
Well, I think God can purify us, and he can overcome that. But it takes an effort. I don't know, to be honest with you.
Yeah, no,
for
gotcha.
Each person, it might be different, but there's something that has to be undone before that can be done. You know, you mentioned Brad Wilcox earlier.
Yeah.
Another great book you may know of is called Cheap Sex by Mark Rignorus, and he talks about the fact that today young women are more likely to have early sex with men that they know that they're not going to marry, men that are not very high on their list of men that they'd want to be with. And so if the man she doesn't want to be with, what he learned from those interviews, they're more likely to go ahead and have sex.
Wow.
Early on. But if it's a man that has some potential, he has a higher quality kind of man in her eyes, she's going to hold off. Because there's a wisdom that women know, you know, if I hold off, we're likely to develop a deeper relationship. And that's just a little impulse toward chastity. If you just crank that up to chastity, what you're doing is you're attracting, putting out the strongest attraction to the best man that God would have for you. Because the body is holy.
Yeah.
Scripture tells us that our bodies are joined to Christ. Yeah. And St. Paul even says in this same passage, if you join... Would you have me take Christ's members and make them the members of a prostitute? He says, God forbid. But the opposite side of that is that God gives us these holy, sacred bodies to join with another holy, sacred body in His way and in His will. And when we do that, we exemplify the Holy Trinity, the love of God for within the Godhead itself. And that's an amazing, just an incredible thing to think of. And that is what we give up for a little cheap pleasure in fornication. It boggles the mind.
It's so well said. My guest today, Father Paul Solins. He's actually a married priest. And if you want to join us, we'd love to hear your experience. Maybe you've encountered this. Maybe you're struggling with it. Maybe you're... You know, you never heard this before, and this is an eye-opening experience. If you have a question, a comment, or you want to just pull up a chair and join the conversation, let me give you the telephone number, and I'll go to the phones. 888-914-9149, 888-914-9149. I think this is a very important conversation that your kids should be aware of. As culture sends one message, the church gives them another, one that leads to true freedom and gives them the tools they need for lifelong marriage. Mark is listening in Delaware. He's a public school psychologist. Mark, thanks for joining us. Good afternoon.
Thank you very much, Drew. Good afternoon to you and you, Father. The reason I'm calling is I heard something about, you know, the indoctrination or the things that they're sharing with kids as young as kindergarten. And I just want to share, I'm a nationally certified school psychologist. I was nominated for School Psychologist of the Year for my state. Great. I'm just sharing that for credibility. I want to let you know that, you know, this year when we had those events with the murder of George Floyd, my district wanted to share that, what are teachers going to do about the murder of George Floyd? They wanted to share that information with kids as young as kindergarten. So when I respectfully voiced my opinion that, you know, if we're going to really have this difficult, complex conversation about police brutality and the murder of George Floyd, can we afford to continue to be silent that the number one killer of African Americans in this country is abortion?
Yeah.
I also voiced my concern that I'm not hearing anybody talking about the little kids playing in parks getting hit by stray bullets. Yeah. And, you know, I was suspended. I've been gaslighted. I've been intimidated. I've been told that they'll come for my family. Different stuff that was really uncalled for, and I'm taking, you know, appropriate actions to right that situation. But I want to let everyone know who's listening about a company that is a curriculum consultant working from Connecticut to Georgia called Akoben LLC. Now, Akoben, A-K-O-B-E-N, is a term, an African word that means a call to war or battle cry. And what they're doing is they are mobilizing the socialist-leaning class of teachers. They're indoctrinating the children. They're mobilizing us to be disruptors, okay? And there's a very specific blueprint, because I've worked closely being a school psychologist with the organization. There's a very specific blueprint for handling dissenters as well. And, you know, what is going on in the public schools, and I know I'm not alone, resembles a Maoist struggle session like Mao Zedong China.
Mm-hmm.
It really is. Dissenters are really gaslighted, silenced, intimidated. And I just wanted to share my perspective, you know, about the psychological, you could call it a psychological war that's going on.
Hey, Mark, first of all, let me commend you for standing up and speaking the truth. And you're absolutely right. You know, you take a look at the child in the womb, especially African-American children. I mean, they're being exterminated at a horrific rate. And God will bless you for standing for truth. I'm going to be praying for you. I know our listeners are as well. We need good psychologists in school that will speak the truth regardless of what happens. And I pray for, you know, a real victory in whatever legal, you know, approaches you need to take. But, Father, look, you are a professor as well. You heard Mark's story. I'm sure he's not alone out there. And that's this whole Black Lives Matter George Floyd issue. And we got the sexual issue. We got a lot of things going on in our educational institutions that should have parents and Americans very concerned.
Right. Right. And it's the indoctrination of young children. You know, if it was middle school or high school and they wanted to have these conversations, it might be a little different. It still would be a little overbearing, but to drill down to the youngest children and to kind of politicize their learning is just unthinkable, really. But on the matter of sexuality, there's also indoctrination, even at that young level. You know, while I was waiting to come on, I went and looked this up. I knew it was there. It's a Planned Parenthood website they have material that they provide for schools for the stages of child sexual development. And here they go. At 3 to 4 years old, listen to this. Children at this age may begin masturbating. Copy adult sexual behaviors.
Wow.
3 to 4 years old.
Wow.
This is straight out of Kinsey. This is ridiculous. And then they move on and on. And at age 13, they say, teens at this age may initiate sexual activity. And go on, and they go on and describe more of these. You know, on this whole sense of development, there's this sense that what we are calling fornication, they are calling sex play in this document.
Wow.
And it's natural.
You know, I came across an article, and I thought we could talk about it today. That's why I invited Father Sullins to join us, a very gifted researcher from the Ruth Institute and a former professor of sociology at Catholic University. The headline grabbed my attention. I believe it was written by Monsignor Charles Pope. I think I saw it in the Register. And Jake, maybe we could post it. I'll put it up on our website. The headline is this: a reminder that fornication is a serious sin, and it can exclude you from heaven. And he goes through, in his article, what the sins of the flesh can do and our call to purity and you know, what Christ has said and why fornication and other sexual sins are among the most serious. Why does God find such offense to those? What is it about purity? Father, it's good to have you. Let's jump right in the phones. Maybe we can answer some of those questions too. But let's go to Nina, who's been waiting for a while. She's in Westmont, Illinois. Hi, Nina.
Hi, Nina.
Hi, Drew. Hi, Father. Okay, so I am part of a new ministry in the Diocese of Joliet, and it is based on the book by Neil Lozano called Unbound.
Yep.
And Father Burke Masters from There on Relevant Radio and Father Stephen Borello invited many of us who are people of faith in our parishes in the Diocese of Joliet to join this ministry. What I have found, this is an answer to your question about what we can do when we have had in general, we've had previous relationships with different sexual relationships with people. And through this ministry, which is a deliverance ministry, one of the keys, this is based on the five key method of relationship with God the Father, is that God the Father wants us to be able to be free of things that keep us from being loved by Him and loving Him completely. So in the third key, we make a statement, and everything that is shared by the person who's receiving ministry is basically renounced or rebuked using the name of Jesus, the power of the name of Jesus. So in this key, we would renounce soul ties, and soul ties are relationships, sexual relationships we have with other people. Mm-hmm. And we would say, in the name of Jesus, I renounce every unholy tie with, and you name the person, we'll say John. I renounce every physical and spiritual tie with John, and I take back the authority that I gave to him or that he took from me. And I have prayed with people that they have either had willing sexual relationships, they have been raped, they have been used, they have been manipulated. And through this process, through this statement, in the name of Jesus, the you just see in their whole demeanor as you're sitting with them, the sense of relaxation, the emotion that comes up, the tears that roll.
Yeah.
As they realize that they, not alone, never alone, we could do nothing alone, but in the name of Jesus, with the power of the Holy Spirit and the will of God the Father, that we can be free of these relationships. We can't take back our actions, but we can allow God to heal us.
Yeah, I love that. Hey, Nina, can you do me a favor? Could you email us that prayer so I can post it on Twitter? Do you have it?
I sure will, Drew.
Email it or...
Yes, and I'll send...
Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, and I'm sure that Father Burke Masters, I know he has a Monday morning segment, and I know he's spoken about the book Unbound.
I'm going to have to get him on.
But I know that it would be great for you to have Neil Lozano or even his son, Matt Lozano, because they go around the country and around the world teaching this Unbound method I just think that, I mean, so many times, Drew, you've brought up things, and I just feel like, oh, that could be unbound, that could be unbound. And, you know, it's the simplest of things, and I have done this with my family, with my mother, with my relatives, but so much more power is with people I don't know. And in, like, 1 hour, the things that people will share about their lives, especially the hurtful relationships, and I've done this with young girls that I am, like, my mouth drops what they share that they have done in junior high, like you said, you know, the things that they were exposed to, the things that girls say with girls and boys say with boys and boys say with girls. I am just like, what in the world? I didn't know these things. I'm not old, but wasn't exposed to these things. And obviously it's because of the internet and the things that are instant out there. We can't keep up with it. You know, we can't, because as soon as we think we got it, something else worse has come up. Well, so I think that this is just one of the options out there.
Nina, thank you for sharing that with everybody. I mean, that's fantastic. Send that prayer and the link. We'll see if we can't get Neil Lozano on to talk about it. You can email me, drew@relevantradio.com, or just send it into the show some other way. But we are grateful for it. Father, I want you to comment on what Nina said, because you know, that sounds so liberating to so many different people. Your thoughts on the spiritual aspect of all that. The healing that comes. God wants to heal. God wants to restore.
The Bible says that someone who commits fornication is committing idolatry. It's a form of idolatry, of placing something, your pleasure or someone's body or maybe your emotional relationship with that person, in the place of God. And that has to be dethroned somehow. I think there are maybe more than one way to do that, but this is a particularly powerful and direct way to do that. And there are many people in our culture today, because the culture has turned evil. And so a little of what seems like innocuous influence of the culture in our thoughts and in our behaviors, well, everybody does it. It can't be that bad.
Right.
It's not that important. That attitude opens persons up to real, definite evil. Pope Francis is so wise to ask us to say the St. Michael prayer after every Mass, because it is true. Satan would love to upend us, and he's not some vague idea. He's out there gunning for us. And so to confront in such a direct way, to unbind, which is a very scriptural thing to do, is to find a freedom that creates people, recreates them away in kind of purity and chastity. It sounds great. Thank you for sharing that.
All right. I got a couple of calls here. Jolene or Pam, Jake? All right, Joylene, good afternoon. You are on the air. You got to make it kind of quick if you could.
Sure. I have my name's Joylene. I have a 2 and 3 year old children, a 2 year old girl and a 3 year old boy. And I'm curious if I could get some advice. My 2 and 3 year old, even at this young age, have shown signs of like rubbing their genitals. And I've addressed it with their pediatrician, who is not super concerned, but I'm curious, what advice can I have? We're a very faith-filled family. We try and address it with them about, you know, with sanctity and the intensity of their bodies, and I'm not exactly sure how to address it from a faith focus.
All right, great. All right, Father, you only have about a minute and a half to respond, but I'll give you the final thoughts.
I'm sorry, I don't know. I'm not a psychologist. I would not know exactly what's going on there, except to say that I've been in a number of other situations or dealt with children in my family and in others who do things that we interpret as sexual, but to the child that's doing it, it's not that at all. They just don't know. And you think, oh, wow, they're pointing to their crotch, or they're just kind of scratching themselves, and for them it's like, well, I was scratching my tummy. It doesn't have the same sexual overtone that it does to someone on the other side of puberty, where those abilities and those feelings and those hormones get kicked on and come into play. So I would be real reticent to move too quickly to a sexual interpretation.
Yeah.
You've just been listening to Dr. J and Drew Mariani discussing premarital sex, pornography, test driving, repentance, and more on this segment of Relevant Radio's The Drew Mariani Show. The Ruth Institute is a nonprofit educational organization equipping effective advocates for family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. Our podcasts can be found online at ruthinstitute.org and iTunes. And as always, they're under a Creative Commons license. If you've enjoyed them, please share them with friends. Like us on Facebook, check out the site, and subscribe to our weekly newsletter to stay informed.